हेलो एवरीवन, वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 4, रिप्रोडक्टिव हेल्थ। दिस इज़ द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ द चैप्टर, क्लास 12th, बायोलॉजी। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स: मेडिकल टर्मिनेशन ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी और MTP, सेक्सुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीजेज एंड देन इनफर्टिलिटी। What is medical termination of pregnancy or MTP? It is the intentional or voluntary termination of pregnancy before full term, and it is also called as induced abortion. All over the world, in a year, 45 to 50 million MTPs are performed. That is 1/5 of the total number of conceived pregnancies. MTP helps to decrease the population, but many countries have not legalized MTP due to emotional, ethical, religious and social issues. Government of India legalized MTP in 1971 with some strict conditions to check illegal female feticide. What is female feticide? Means aborting the female fetus. So, Government of India legalized MTP, but with some strict conditions. What are the importance of MTP? First, to avoid unwanted pregnancies due to casual intercourse, due to failure of contraceptive used during coitus, or due to rapes. It is also important in cases where continuation of pregnancy could be harmful to mother or to fetus or to both. When the MTPs are safe? MTPs are safe during the first trimester, that is up to 12 weeks of pregnancy. But in second trimester, abortions are very risky. What are the problems related with MTPs? First problem is, majority of the MTPs are performed illegally. Second, misuse of amniocentesis test for fetal sex determination, and if the fetus is female, it is followed by MTP. Such practices are dangerous for the young mother and for the fetus. But what is this amniocentesis test for? You can see the diagram. There is a fetus in the amniotic cavity, and in the amniotic cavity there is an amniotic fluid. So, in amniocentesis, what is done? In this, some amniotic fluid of the fetus is taken to analyze the fetal cells and dissolved substances. And it is used to test the presence of genetic disorders and survivability of the fetus. Government of India enacted the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Amendment Act 2017. To reduce illegal abortion and consequent maternal mortality and morbidity. According to this act, a pregnancy may be terminated within the first 12 weeks on the opinion of a registered medical practitioner. And if the pregnancy is between 12 to 24 weeks, then 2 registered medical practitioners must be of the opinion. Then only the pregnancies can be terminated. What are sexually transmitted diseases? Diseases transmitted through sexual intercourse are called sexually transmitted diseases or sexually transmitted infections, STDs or STIs, venereal diseases, VD, or reproductive tract infection, RTI. Example dekhiye: gonorrhea, syphilis, genital herpes, chlamydiasis, genital warts, trichomoniasis, hepatitis B, and HIV leading to AIDS. Hepatitis B and HIV are also transmitted, first by sharing of injection needles, surgical instruments, etc. Second, by transfusion of blood. Third, from infected mother to fetus. But one important point is, except hepatitis B, genital herpes and HIV, other diseases are completely curable if detected early and treated properly. What are the symptoms of sexually transmitted diseases? Early symptoms dekhe kya hai? Itching, fluid discharge, slight pain, swelling, etc. in the genital region. But if absence or less significant early symptoms are there, and due to some social stigma, the infected persons, they do not go to the doctor, they do not consult a doctor, and this lead to complications such as pelvic inflammatory diseases. You can see the diagram. Pelvic inflammation is there, abortions, stillbirths, ectopic pregnancies, means pregnancies are taking place in other place other than uterus. Here you can see in the diagram, the pregnancy is there in the fallopian tube instead of uterus. This is called as ectopic pregnancy. It may lead to infertility or cancer of the reproductive tract. Prevention of sexually transmitted diseases. First, avoid sex with unknown partner or multiple partners. Second, always use condoms during coitus. Third, in case of doubt, go to a qualified doctor for early detection and get complete treatment. All persons are vulnerable to STDs, and these are very high among persons in the age group of 15 to 24 years. Come to infertility. What is infertility? It is the inability to conceive or produce children even after 2 years of unprotected sexual cohabitation. Second reason for infertility kya hai? Physical, congenital, diseases, drugs, immunological or even psychological. What is the treatment? These disorders can be treated in infertility clinic using assisted reproductive technologies or ART. Now see the technologies used to correct the infertility problems. ART, first in vitro fertilization or IVF test tube baby program. Second, gamete intrafallopian transfer, GIFT. Third, intracytoplasmic sperm injection, ICSI. Then artificial insemination and then surrogacy. Come to first, in vitro fertilization or IVF test tube baby program. What is done in this? In this method, ova from the wife, you can see the diagram, ova from the wife or the donor and sperm from the husband or the donor are collected and are induced to form the zygote under simulated condition in the laboratory. So fertilization is done in the laboratory. That's why the name given, test tube baby. And then this is followed by embryo transfer. There are two types of embryo transfer. First, zygote intrafallopian transfer or GIFT. Second, intrauterine transfer or IUT. What are they? Zygote intrafallopian transfer kya hai? Transfer of zygote or early embryo with up to 8 blastomeres into fallopian tube. So up to 8 blastomeres zygote is transferred to the fallopian tube. Okay, but if the zygote has the more than 8 blastomeres, then the transfer is done in the uterus. So transfer of embryo with more than 8 blastomeres is done in the uterus. This is called as intrauterine transfer or IUT. Embryos formed by in vivo fertilization. In vivo means fertilization within the female is also used for such transfer to assist those females who cannot conceive. Come to second, gamete intrafallopian transfer or GIFT. Here what is done? Transfer of an ovum from a donor. into the fallopian tube of another female who cannot produce ovum. So there is a transfer of ovum from the donor to other female who cannot produce ovum, but she can provide suitable environment for fertilization and development. This is called as gamete intra-fallopian transfer or gift. Third, intracytoplasmic sperm injection, a laboratory procedure in which a single sperm from a male partner is injected directly into an egg from female partner. After the fertilization, the embryo is implanted into the woman's uterus. This is called as intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Come to fourth, artificial insemination, AI technique. What is done in this? The semen collected from the husband or a donor is artificially introduced into the vagina or the uterus of the female. Artificial insemination in the uterus is known as intrauterine insemination or IUI. When this technique is used, this technique is useful for the male partner having inability to inseminate female or having low sperm counts. Come to surrogacy. Here, a woman or surrogate mother bears a child. For a couple unable to produce children because the wife is infertile or unable to carry, the surrogate mother, the surrogate is impregnated through artificial insemination or implantation of an embryo produced by IVF. Problems of ART. First problem kya hai iski? It requires higher precision handling by specialized professionals and expensive instrumentation. Therefore, these facilities are available only in a very few centers. Second, emotional, religious, and social problems are also associated with it. Legal adoption is one of the best methods for couples looking for parenthood. So, that's all about the chapter. Thank you very much for staying with me. Do the test which is given in the description box. Subscribe the channel for getting the information about my new video. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.